James, very good drive, sir.
Thank you. I had my own little track day out there, which I really needed because I'm a little slow out here, but it's a great track and I can't wait to come back.
Well, you obviously were quick enough to finish third in your class, so congratulations. Good job.
Thank you. And I'd like to thank Mike Rossini, Rossini Racing Products, for making this all awesome.
Good job. Let's open those champagne bottles, guys.
Saved it, but Joe Moser said something, and he is all over the back of that yellow CRX SI. Those two in the test day and throughout qualifying were just leaning on each other big time in terms of pace. Kevin Ruck, that bright orange Acura Integra, sits in third. Scott?
Spray some champagne and celebrate, guys. Thanks.
Good job, Dave. Pushing over to Group 6, and it is indeed Ryan Price, Joe Moser, and Kevin Ruck for second and third in ITA.
Boy, James,
we're watching see that group come by, but right at the moment, working lap 3 with 17 to go is Ryan Price at 51, Joe Moser at 63, Kevin Ruck at 56, the top 5 in ITA.
Jake Jordan, after dropping off of Bill Perry, that opening couple of laps a little bit, has found some pace and is now making a move. Jake Jordan going for the lead in ITC down the back straight, pulls up alongside Perry. They're side by side, and Jordan is through as they get to turn 9. So Jake Jordan has gone to the front in ITC. Meanwhile, in ITA, it is Price, and he has now opened up about a 5-car length lead over the 63 Moser in the yellow CRX SI, and the gap between Price and Ruck has not changed. It's just that Ruck is running up on Moser, and up front Price is easing away from Moser. Then you go back to fourth, it's a bit of a gap back to the number 3 of Robert Moser, but that lead trio right now with Price stretching it ever more down the back straight has to turn 9.
James Jordan has indeed taken the lead in ITC over William Perry, while early in the IT truck. Charles Fograff running third in ITC. Ryan Price, Joe Moser, Kevin Ruck. Price in the auto, Moser in the Honda. Here comes Kevin Ruck in an Acura.
The record that they have, and they just continue to absolutely duke it out. It looks like Jinx may have just a little bit stronger engine right now, but Perry back straight. Jordan leading out of seven. But Perry was all over him. And while Perry close enough, he gets a little bit of a toe. He's not able to really run up and get by Jordan. Jinx was able to drive by him last time down the straight. Perry not able to drive by, but at least he's not losing ground. And might be able to do something where he seems to be a little bit stronger when it gets a little busier.
Yeah, Joe Moser had a lot of pressure from Kevin Roque down the front straightaway the previous lap. Really worked the lap 4 with 16 to go. With twice in the lead. Moser in second with 63. The Honda and Kevin Roque and the Acura running in third. Barbara Moser, another Honda, then Dan York rounding out the top five. Here comes an ITC battle. And it's William Perry now who has gone back in front of Jinx Jordan. So Perry into the ITC lead, drop Jordan to second. They come by, not quite nose to tail, but very, very close as Perry takes over the lead in ITC. Working lap 4 with 16 to go.
And I think Ruck may have taken a run at Moser down into 10, so you may have a new second place in ITA.
No, Moser, yeah, that is Kevin Ruck. No, Joe Moser holds on to second place. Kevin Ruck comes by in third, about 2/10 of a second spread between Moser and 63. Chasing Brian Price. Greg, check out William Perry and Jinx Jordan. Perry going back into the lead in ITC over Jinx Jordan.
Yeah, like I said, it looks like Jinx has a little bit better motor, but that last lap, the wrong run down the backstretch, Perry was close enough to be able to trap him and stay within a car length. And Perry looks to be really good on the brakes and was obviously able to dive down underneath and get that spot down to turn 10. And then get through 10-8, 10-B-11, 12, and then his run up through 3 in the S's. He really dropped the hammer and has been able to open up a little bit of ground on Jinx at this point. And Jinx not close enough at this stage to be able to really give him a go of going down into turn 10.
Watching
an ITC battle, but suddenly Moser is within a car length as they get to turn 9, and he is bringing Ruck with him, so that battle in ITA is now 3 cars strong.
And William Perry has pulled out quite a lead over Jinx Jordan now as they come out from underneath the bridge. And you're right, it's nose to tail battle. Coming through turn 12 is Brian Price with Joe Moser all over him. Bit of a gap to Kevin Ruck, but it is Moser, the yellow Honda. Looks like he's taking a look. Trying to go underneath Brian Price. Price is trying to shut the door. Look like they may be even side by side as they go up from 1 into 2. It's Brian Price at 51 who's led for the drop of the green flag. But Joe Moser now, that little yellow Honda CRX, the 63, making a bid for the lead. Marking lap 6 with 14 to go.
Wasn't able to get it done, but he is within a couple of lengths now. Price as they go through the S's. And Perry, yes, he does have that lead in ITC. ITC battle is leaving turn 7, the ITA battle entering 6. And we're going to see now, we'll have them both on the same straight and see what happens. And right now, the pace of Price and Moser has drawn them a little bit clear of Kevin Ruck. So we'll see what happens here. Perry, he's got a good run and had a steam built up down that straight. And Price now has opened that margin up to about 5 car lengths. They go by Paul Brewer, the old IT truck entry out there. Stays out of the way and lets Moser through. Looks like he may have.
Watching for the ITC battle, which is quickly being caught by the lead ITA car. Brian Price under attack from 63 Joe Moser. And they're going to catch that right at the apex of turn 12. Brian Price is trying to force his way through, not quite being able to do it. Moser trying to get through as well. So Jinx Jordan, second to William Perry at the moment, has Brian Price, the leader, overall leader in an ITA, going by him. Then Joe Moser going by him as well. Moser trying to stay in touch with Price as they ran up on the ITC battle.
halfway down to turn six. The margin really unchanged there. It's about five car lengths. Make that four now. Is looks like Moser able to get in a little deeper into six under braking. Rutt now finally is able to get by Perry and clear that ITC lead battle. Meanwhile, Price out of turn seven. Moser looking a little bit closer again. Back to about three car lengths as he makes the launch. And let's see what happens here. Yeah, it's about four car lengths now. Now five. Then here comes Rock. He's a good 15 back. And Perry has stretched that margin over Jinx Jordan once again to a good six or seven car lengths, Scott.
Again, working lap seven with 13 to go. Watching for Brian Price and Joe Moser come out from underneath the bridge. Price leading for the drop of the green flag. Here he comes down through turn 12. He's got that Honda CRX right behind him. Price very smooth through turn 12. Moser right behind him in his tire tracks. It's Price at 51. Moser in 63, first and second. Now the ITC battle coming by. It's William Perry with Jinx Jordan right behind him. Price to the Mazda Miata, Moser to the yellow Honda CRX.
Boy, you bet. It is now Moser's place of shadow. I mean, he's that close. And of course, it's interesting. Those old CRX SIs have very short wheelbase. So when they get in the quick transition parts of the track, he's actually very, very effective in that spot of the track. But in these long, high-speed duration corners, turn 12, turn 1, those type of corners, that is where, if you watch Moser very carefully, correction is that short wheelbase dances through those long corners, not quite as stable. And of course, what that means, Scott, is when they get down into that tight left right at turn 10, 10A and 10B as they call it, that little CRX very good through there. And he can probably grab the throttle just a little bit sooner and get after it. But now they get in that long straight, and Price has about three lengths. Now that's as close as Moser's been in the last four or five laps, making that run down this long back straight here, so we'll see if he's able to do anything with it. And Perry now has been able to open that margin up just a little bit more over Jinx Jordan, as we're seeing some of the other ITA cars, including Robert Moser and that red Honda Civic, is making his way through that ITC battle.
Perry, Price, and Moser are still about the same spread as last time. However, they're about to run up on some traffic between probably turns 1 and 2, possibly at 3. Gray Forest and Ed Forest running 12th and 13th overall. Price and Moser are about to run up upon them. And depending on where they catch them, Greg, as we know around Road Atlanta, this could be Moser's opportunity. It also could give Price an opportunity to maybe stretch that lead out and relieve some of that pressure that Moser has been applying to him. Working lap 9 with 11 to go.
Well, they're running up on the back of that AMC machine very, very quickly as they get down into the turn 5 area. Just enough, and Moser, and when they got down to turn 6, there was maybe a couple of feet between his front and the back of Price's Miata. And Price, well, I tell you what, under that kind of pressure, he was spot on perfect exiting turn 7 and getting a run out of there. Didn't look like he made any kind of a bobble. And boy, he needed that. But Moser now close enough. He's going to get the opportunity to trap Price a little bit. He is right there. He's not losing a thing. He's very close, and it's all a matter of whether he can get down deep under the brakes down into turn 10 and make that work, or what kind of a defense Price throws at him. But they are an absolute covered by a blanket heading down into 10.
Watch to see if Brian Price is able to hold off Joe Moser. Moser applying constant pressure throughout the race track here, and the answer is no. Moser gets by. Here comes Price, though. He's going to try to attack. He draws him behind the CRX. Price going to the inside, going to turn 1. It's going to be a braking duel and then an acceleration duel as Price times the move beautifully. Moser at the start-finish line leading. Brian Price drafting by into turn 1, so Price retakes the lead. Kevin Ruckhardt's 3rd, Robert Moser 4th, Edward York 5th. William Perry still leading the 19C, but Greg, that battle between Moser and Price heating up even more if that's possible.
Yeah, Price feeling the heat. He ran a little wide coming out of turn 3, dropped by offside set of tires just a slightly. I see a little puff of red Georgia dust pop up into the air. Didn't seem to slow him down at all. And has actually now got about two car lengths over Moser as they get down into turn six. Make that turn in, use that banking to get a bad sort of slingshot up through six. Hard under the brakes here at seven. And now that key exit, no mistakes on. It's Moser that runs a little wide. Drops those laps on the outside of that exit curving. But again, that's a front-wheel drive car, so he just keeps that foot planted. But it did cost him. He lost a couple more car lengths, just that little bit of bouncing around. Boy, that's how key that momentum is here. It's just that close right now. And watching Jake's Jordan now is closed up again onto the back. He's now within like three car lengths as they get down into turn seven. So this ITC lead battle's not settled yet either.
We're at the halfway point, working lap 10 with 10 to go. Weiss regaining the lead as they went into turn one. Holds onto that lead as they go through turn 12. Now working lap 11 with 9 to go is Weiss with Moser right behind him. And we will be seeing Kevin Rupp come through in third, watching for that ITC battle.
Thank you, Greg.
but Moser suddenly now, that's got to be a good 15 car length lead that he's got over Price. So I don't know if it was down at 5 or I can't see it, or whether it was on the run from 1 to 3. Down at turn 1, we're getting a report from turn 1 from our great group of spotters up here in turn 5. Something happened to Price down at 1, and it cost him dearly as Moser now has himself a sizable lead.
That battle for his 7th between Willie Fee and Ted Thorpe. Willie Fee in 84 and Ted Thorpe in the 01, and they are battling over 7th position. Fee currently has it. Thorpe is trying to get it. That's the 2 positions you're talking about, Greg, and that is very close at the moment. That battle heads towards you as well. Not had a report on Ryan Price, but as you said, Price obviously making a mistake to lose that amount of ground to Moser.
Gal, again, I got some updates from the spotters out here, and Price just got in too hot into one, floated off the outside, and had a little bit of a rough ride. Moser was throwing underneath, and that's all it took, obviously. And then battle between Fee and Thorpe, there have been a couple of times when they have been absolutely nose to tail. Then they either catch somebody or somebody catches them in terms of lapping them, splits that up, and then eventually they find each other again. That's been a real fun one to watch. Right now, Willie Fee actually has a little bit of breathing room over Thorpe, as he, in fact,
check that. It was the last car. Sorry about that, Greg.
That's a snuck through underneath, clean as could be. And then when it got down into the break zone five, Bryce was able to get by as well. Great job of flagging, a great job of reacting to the flags by that lap car. Boy, you love to see that work like that. And Bryce now throwing everything but the kitchen sink in his pursuit. Drops those left side tires well off the outside of the exit curve down at 7.
Battle for 7th at ITA, Greg, 84 Willie Fee still able to keep that red Honda CRX of Ted Thornton 0-1 behind him. That is for 7th and 8th in ITA.
Yeah, Willie got some breaks in traffic and has driven really well. Has been able to open that up. Looks to be about 10 car lengths now he's got over Thornton. And that's as big a lead as he's had so far today.
William Perry continues to lead over Jake Jordan. At least here at start finish line as we're working lap 17 with 3 to go. Their price has dropped quite a ways back off of Moser. I don't know if it's tires or possibly he may have damaged something that off in turn 1, but it appears at least here again at start finish the price is dropping back for Moser as opposed to gaining ground on him and applying pressure to Moser again.
Well, it may have been that he just lost a lot of momentum when he ran wide exiting 7 on his last lap.
Gathered himself. He looked like he was back up to speed, at least what again on the first straightaway that we have seen, as he was getting by the ITC battle as well. So it's Moser, Brian Price, and Kevin Ruck. And Ruck now, the change of that off by Price, seems like he might have gained a little bit of ground on Price. So check out Joe Moser at 63, Brian Price at 51, and Kevin Ruck at 73. Looks like that's closing up again, Greg.
Yeah, oh, I looked at myself. I think Ruck may have a problem. He suddenly has lost another chunk of time. Moser, when he got caught out behind that moment for the number 66 at Tucker and the 21, or the, I believe it was the 21 that joined the Brewer, that definitely hurt him a little bit. I think that's why you see Price a little bit closer than he has been. Moser now exiting 7, and Price exiting 7 as well. So that is definitely a bit closer. Moser flashing his headlights at another car that he's coming up on here. Obviously doing everything he can to make sure that people see him as he comes by. It's the 17 of Dave Montgomery. And, oh, definitely Price is now. I think that margin has been at least a third of the deficit that Price had to Moser is gone. And it was all because of Moser having a checkup coming out of 7 because of that little moment down there, that last lap. I don't know how many laps are left. I don't know whether there's enough there for Price. But at least now he's got a sense of it.
Working lap 18 with 2 to go. And I seem to be saying this every time that Moser's been coming out from underneath the bridge, but he is in traffic once again. Price also in traffic, and Greg Price is making some inroads. We are working lap 19 now. Next time by, one lap to go, and Price is definitely gaining ground on Moser. I don't know if he has enough time, not just to catch him, but to try and get by Moser once he gets up to him. But definitely Price is closing on Moser. We're working lap 19. Next time by, one lap to go.
Yeah, that's getting to be a pretty compelling little battle, that's for sure.
Greg.
Yeah.
Got a report. 63 Joe Moser off at turn 1. slid off into the gravel trap. I do not believe he's going to be able to get back on. So look at Brian Price. You don't believe you're going to see Moser, but you will see Brian Price, who now has inherited the lead from Joe Moser.
Well, I was just going to say, I saw Price come up over three and no yellow CRX. So I knew something had gone wrong, and as you jumped on it, hearing that call, problem again. So both of these guys, both Price and Moser, have had problems at turn one. Price lost ground. Looks like Moser may have lost the race in terms of being stuck in the gravel, because we have not seen him make an appearance yet. So, boy, that's a tough one. Moser had driven brilliantly. Price had been quicker in qualifying.